everybody. This is your girl, Megan Thee Stallion, aka the Hot Girl Coach, reporting live with the future president of the United States.
Everybody,
what do you have to say to the American people?
We are not going back.
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Did y'all happen to see Kamala's campaign event in Atlanta? Y'all, it was the craziest thing I've ever seen at a campaign event. But it's just like Atlanta, is it not? No, it's not. Let's be real. It's what Kamala thinks Atlanta is all about. It's just like Hillary with the hot sauce in her purse. Y'all, she turned on a whole different character for Atlanta. She had them bump, rock, shaking on stage, shaking their moneymakers. No, the campaign event was not at the Blue Flame. No, it wasn't at Magic City. Y'all didn't have to go to any place like that to see Kamala, because she brought Magic City to the campaign event in the version of Meg Thee Stallion. And I must say, y'all, as trashy as this presentation was, when I saw it, I said, that's the most clothes I've seen Meg have on in quite some time. And usually when you see her with clothes like that, they're see-through. I'm sure in her mind, she thought she was decent. But in the minds of thinking folk, Black folks who trying to be something, Black folks who trying to be about something, Black folks who trying to have integrity, and we know, y'all, it's a conversation we don't like to have in public on platforms like this, but we have these conversations amongst ourselves, and we know there's certain groups among us, and we look at them with the side eye, because we know they not like us. Well, y'all, Kamala turned on her Southern accent, brought out her booty-shaking dancers, and I thought it was disheartening to see. But you know, sometimes when your faith get low, that's when God will step in and show you something that will lift you up and encourage you. And y'all, I was encouraged by the amount of folks who came out in disagreement with this presentation. Folks who felt like I felt. Like it was trashy. Like it was garbage. Like you wouldn't dare do that if you was at them folks' cookout. But when you come round here, you get to talking different and acting different. Acting funny, acting like it's abnormal to you, acting like we abnormal to you. All right, y'all, I ain't gonna overtalk it. Let's enjoy the blowback that Kamala Harris is facing by Black folk who understand that even though sometimes we let you come to the cookout, we know where you're really from. We know who you really are. We know what your background really is. And we know how you got where you got. Y'all check out these clips.
Megan, what is this? At the ATL rally event, like what? You need to pipe it down, honey, and do that somewhere else, but not at this type of event. Like, very, silence is very loud.
So out of all the people she could have chose, Kamala Harris picked Meg Thee Stallion to open up her rally in Atlanta. And that's nothing against Meg Thee Stallion. I love a good twerk every now and then. But optics matter, folks. Optics matter.
The Black community fall for this cringy-ass bullshit.
Or as my friend Quavo would say, he does not walk it like he talks it.
Name me a time in Black culture history you heard someone say, even after the song Walk It Like You Talk It came out, say, man, he ain't walking it like he talk it. Nobody says that, bro. Nobody. Then on top of that, she has this weird accent. Where is this weird accent coming from? Because this is how you normally talk.
Your vote is your power. So please make sure your voice is heard this November and register.
And you all helped us win in 2020, and we're going to do it again in 2024.
But y'all notice how she talked when she was on an LGBTQ set. Versus how she was talking when she had her rally in Atlanta, Georgia today. Kamala, you are not Southern. You have no Southern draw. You're not from any part of any Southern state. You have no ties to the South whatsoever. So why are you talking like that? If my memory serves me right, ain't she from California? Mama's Indian, daddy's Indian and Jamaican. So where's the Black culture Southern draw coming from? Like I told y'all before this woman had any rallies, I told y'all this weeks ago, y'all fall for that. I eat fried chicken and I eat watermelon and I listen to rap music. Bullshit if y'all want to. Y'all gonna be hollering after about 3 to 4 months of this woman being in office. I'm not bullshitting with y'all. All skin folk and kin folk, and she ain't even skin folk. She Indian, Asian.
Yo, so I watch, you know, the rally that Kamala Harris put together in Atlanta, and that was embarrassing. You have Megan Thee Stallion on stage twerking. And it goes to show you that that's the best that she could do. That goes to show you what she thinks of us. She thinks that's what we want to see. And I just hate to see it. And it's just, it was just a clown show. It was a circus. You know what I'm saying? It's like, what out of all the musicians, all the things you could put together, you chose Megan Thee Stallion to twerk in on stage. It was just ridiculous. If y'all don't vote this year, I completely understand why. I know that sounds bad, but yeah, that was ridiculous. And that's the same thing Biden did. I remember when he got Cardi B, he interviewed her, and it's just like, what are you interviewing Cardi B for? Once again, it goes to show you they try to appeal to us by hip-hop and stuff like that. Like, that's what all of us want to see. Like, no, that doesn't stand for all of us. What do you think, Corey?
So Kamala Harris brought her fake Southern accent having ass to Atlanta yesterday. And she got up on that stage. Before she got up on that stage, she came out to Quavo and Megan Thee Stallion, got up on that presidential rally stage and started twerking in her blue Democratic outfit, which was a small skirt with a crop top. I'm highly disappointed in the city of Atlanta. I'm highly disappointed in the city of Atlanta. She came here, she's from California, but she came here with a fake Southern accent. Look at the way that she was talking, trying to get our attention. You're trying to get our vote, and people, the crowd goes crazy. Like Quavo says, they walk it like I talk it. And the crowd went wild. Are y'all serious, Black people? Is this all we're worth in Atlanta? Are y'all serious? She comes putting on this fake accent. She's an Indian from California with a white mother. She's never lived in the South. She's married to a Caucasian man. Where did this accent come from? This entire speech was a cringe. It was hard to watch. Like, my bones were aching while watching this speech. This wasn't even a speech. This was a circus, a clown show. Come on, y'all. We got to do better than this, Atlanta.
Maybe it's just me, but with Meg Thee Stallion at the Kamala Harris rally, does it just not feel forced? It feels out of place. It's not genuine. And I get it. Kamala wants all the Black vote. So you get a Black rapper to rap her song, a popular song. You get another Black rapper from Atlanta to talk. And he says some Black stuff. I forgot the quote he said, but it was something that he probably put in the song. But it just does not feel genuine. Like, I understand you want to pander to the crowd, but it feels so forced. Am I the only one that feels that way? What are you doing? My bad, my dog over here tripping. But it just feels so forced. It feels so out of place. And like, every time I see it, I cringe. Cause it's like, why are y'all saying all this stuff? Cause it's corny. Like, who is her writers? Who was planning all of this? Whoever it is in charge of this, do better. Because you're not making her that much likable. Like, am I going to vote for her? Probably, because I'm super against Project 25. Because that is a whole nother topic. And I'm still looking into it. But it's so forced. It makes me not really like her for real.
Megan, I'm going to hold your hand when I say this. That wasn't it, my sister. And I love you. It's no beef between us. You know, honestly, you're the only woman I would ever consider, right? So when I tell you this out of love. Like, that wasn't it, my love.
For that to be happening on a presidential stage, like she's performing at a rally for a presidential candidate, I mean, that is just such a sight to see and such an indicator of just the degeneration of politics and culture. I mean, that song was so explicit that she literally couldn't even like perform it. I mean, that video was literally just like noises. And before you even try to call me a hater, I literally been a fan of Megan. I saw her live in like 2018 when she was still touring for Tina Snow. So don't even go there with me. I just think whoever chose Megan to perform, whoever signed off on that for that event, I mean, are we serious?
And there you have it, y'all. All hope is not lost. No, it's not. There are people like you and I who are out here working hard, striving to be better, striving to do better, who understand that this ain't it. Folks who get offended when you do this and direct this at us, but you wouldn't direct this at them? Nah, we know some ain't right. Old folks say, there's a dead cat on the line. Some ain't right about how you see us. Some ain't right about how you approach us. Some ain't right about the fact that you only come around us when you need that vote. Black folk ain't seen you since you've been at the White House. Nah, black folk ain't heard from you since 2020 when you stole that election. Nah, ain't heard from you. Then you wanna come around and play us like we on this level? Now, some of us are on that level, no doubt. We see them all the time. We see them every day in the news. We know the crime rate is too high. The recidivism rate is too high. The drug use rate is too high. The unemployment rate is too high. The home ownership rate is too low. In many cases, our self-esteem is too low. Our drive is too low. Our ambition is too low. What you gonna do about it, Kamala? Ah, we know what you're going to do. You're going to put some booties in our face. Like that's the solution to anything. Well, you ain't earned my vote. And that ain't the way to get it. Y'all let me know what you think about this. I'd love to know your thoughts on this topic. And don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.